Meanwhile, early voting is underway in Florida right now. More than 3 million voters have already cast their ballots. That's up 150% from this time back in 2016. Can you believe it? And in a move that critics say will intimidate and confuse voters, Governor Ron DeSantis' administration is urging local election officials to remove ex-felons who still owe fines and fees from the voter rolls. Let's bring in NBC's Allison Barber live from an early voting location in Miami. She spoke with a former felon who plans to get his say in the election for the very first time. Allison, good to talk to you. So talk us through not only this own voter's experience, but what you're hearing from him and what his efforts are out there on the trail.
Yeah, right. So obviously there is still a lot of issues at play here, a lot of things factoring into whether or not some people will be able to vote in the upcoming election. As you mentioned, there is that issue with a directive coming from the Secretary of State, coming from Governor DeSantis to get former felons who are on the voter rolls off if they are ineligible because of outstanding balances with court fees and court fines. The issue for people who say that's a last-minute purge is they can't get it done in time before election day, and two, they say they feel like they're kind of trying to go after people who might not know they're not technically eligible at the last minute to then challenge the authenticity and the validity of some of those votes. There was an internal memo circulated that we saw. All that aside, though, you do have a lot of people who, for the first time in their lives, are having the opportunity to actually vote, do something that is so vital to democracy. And Angel Sanchez is just one of a few people here in Florida who served their time for a felony conviction and now can finally cast a vote.
And I still remember my first gun trading a Super Nintendo and a little bit of cash money that I had for a gun.
Angel Sanchez grew up in some of Miami's poorest neighborhoods. His mom suffered from a drug addiction. His dad raised him as a single parent.
I was first placed in handcuffs when I was like 9 years old. By the time I was a teenager, I found myself more influenced by my neighborhood and my friends and my peers and what they liked.
By 17, Angel Sanchez was a gang member in and out of jail and finally sent to prison for attempted murder.
And I was on my way to prison with a 30-year sentence and a ninth grade education.
But Angel's story didn't end in prison. Far from it. That's where he began to turn the page when he walked into the prison law library.
But I said to myself, if I ever got a chance to get out, I'm going to go to law school. So let's figure out how that works.
12 years later, Angel left prison with a reduced sentence. While living in a homeless shelter, he started and finished college. In between classes, he worked to pay restitution and his court fees. This spring, he earned his law degree from the University of Miami, graduating in the top 10% of his class. Now, another dream on the horizon, voting in his first presidential election. In 2018, Florida voters passed an amendment to the state's constitution designed to restore voting rights to most felons. Today, Angel works with the group that led that effort.
I agree, actions have consequences, but in a democracy, the consequences should never be tampering with someone's right to vote.
What's up, baby?
He's part of the legal team now fighting the state's ongoing efforts to restrict what's known as Amendment 4.
We oftentimes think justice is a synonym for punishment, and it ends there. But if justice is anything, it's proportional punishment with the opportunity to restore and redeem those we punish.
Angel Sanchez is a former felon, a law school graduate, a role model to his niece and nephews, and in just a few days, a first-time presidential voter.
After Amendment 4 passed, Governor Ron DeSantis signed a law that requires those people who have served their sentences, former felons, to pay all their fines, fees, and restitution before they can be eligible to vote. Because of that, an estimated 900,000 Floridians who have a felony conviction but have served their time as well as their probation are expected to be unable to vote this election solely because they still have outstanding fines and fees. Yasmin?
All right, Allison Barber for us. Thank you, Allison.